You've undoubtedly heard by now that Q-SYS Reflect Enterprise Manager allows you to remotely monitor and manage your Q-SYS system. But what you might not realize is that Enterprise Manager not only monitors native Q-SYS cores and peripherals, but also third-party devices. Enterprise Manager can monitor projectors, lighting consoles, displays, window shade controllers, you name it, as long as they are properly configured to do so in your Q-SYS design. If you've been integrating these device types into your Q-SYS designs already, you know that this happens in one of two ways, either through a plugin or a custom script. Using an Enterprise Manager-enabled Q-SYS plugin is the easiest and fastest route to get Q-SYS to communicate with a third-party device and to get Enterprise Manager to monitor it. If you look in Asset Manager, you'll find a growing library of control plugins available that let you connect and control devices with no additional scripting experience required. And if you find this emblem under the device manufacturer's logo, you'll know that it's ready for Enterprise Manager. All you need to do is install any of these plugins, and you'll be able to add them to your inventory and connect them to your third-party device. Once you add them to your schematic, make sure to go to its properties and select Is Managed. This is what enables the monitoring in Enterprise Manager. You might also want to change the default name so that you can more easily identify it inside Enterprise Manager. Then, all of that device's status data will be visible in the System Inventory and Event Log sections of Enterprise Manager, along with rich device data from your native Q-SYS devices. No other programming is required. It doesn't get much easier than that. But realistically, there are far more devices in the world than we could ever write plugins for. In this case, you or your programmer are probably writing custom Lua scripts using the Q-SYS scripting engine to send and receive information to and from a third-party peripheral. We have an entire curriculum on control training that can help you script those interactions, so we won't get into that right now. The question is, how can you get your custom scripts that's controlling a third-party device to also send status updates and event logs to Enterprise Manager? The answer is this, the Monitoring Proxy component. This component can represent any third-party device that's connected to your Q-SYS core and deliver its information to the Enterprise Manager. You'll find it in your inventory under the Peripherals tab. Let's add a monitoring proxy into the schematic. You'll notice there are several fields that you have to complete in order for it to function, such as manufacturer and model. You should also give your device a suitable name to identify it, as well as select what type of device it is. If none of these type categories are appropriate, you can select Other and specify its type here. All of this information, name, manufacturer, model, and type, they'll help you organize and sort through your devices within Enterprise Manager. The component has a single input pin, which is a status input, to receive the data from your Lua scripting component or block controller. The status information sent from your script will display here in the proxy's status field, which is what gets delivered to the Enterprise Manager. But if you are not up to speed on these tools yet, don't worry. You can still perform some basic monitoring without any custom scripting. After all, for most third-party devices, the critical thing you need to know is simply whether or not there's a valid connection between that device and your Q-SYS core processor. If there is, then your script is probably functioning fine. But if the core can't communicate with that device, well, then that's a failure that you need to know about. An easy way to check if the core can communicate with a device is simply to ping it. You might be familiar with sending a ping command from a Windows command prompt, which is a very basic test of whether a particular IP address can receive data from your source device. Your PC is querying the network for a response from a specific location. You might also know the word in regards to submarine sonar, in which you send a ping out into the world to see if there's anything out there that will reflect it back to you. This is the same idea, but you don't want to ping your third-party device from your PC, you want to ping it from your core. You can do this using the ping components. Go over to the Monitor Components branch of your Schematic Elements library and drag the ping components into your design. In its control panel, all you need is the IP address of the destination device. Once you start the ping, it will send out a test packet once every interval. If the device acknowledges the test packets, then you know your connection between the device and your core is good. If not, then something's wrong. Maybe the network switch between those devices is down or not configured properly. Maybe your device is unplugged. Either way, that's exactly the kind of information you want to know about when managing a system remotely using Enterprise Manager. To make this happen, we simply need to expose the status control pin of this ping component and wire it to our monitoring proxy's status input. That's it. If you switch over to Enterprise Manager, you'll now get confirmation that this device has a healthy connection to the core. If I were to yank the power cable on our device, well, then the ping will fail, send that information to the monitoring proxy, and notify us in Enterprise Manager. One more thing. You may have noticed some log entry controls in the monitoring proxy's control panel. These allow you to publish custom messages to your core's event log, as well as decide at which severity level it should be categorized. While you can decide these manually, most people would control these from their Lua script or block controller based on their interactions with the device. For instance, you could use this to report your projector's lamp temperature or which source is currently selected on a video switch. This is useful information for your event log, and when using the monitoring proxy, those additional events are synchronized up to the Enterprise Manager's event log. And that's it. The monitoring proxy is a simple-to-use tool for monitoring third-party devices in Enterprise Manager. Thanks for watching.